What's up, humans? It's Steven, and we are back with Wednesday. So before I start, because I love this show so much and the vibes and the character of Wednesday, I'm going to attempt to do a drawing for every single episode. I'm going to draw at least one frame of the episode each episode. And so since I thought of this idea after I shot the last one, right now you should be seeing my drawing for episode one. And then in a discussion, you'll see my drawing for episode two. Now, with all that out of the way, allow me to put my detective cap on here. And so I noticed when I was editing the last video, I think I just solved like the mystery of the series. I don't know if it's a big mystery. It was a mystery to me, but I think I solved it. And I'm pretty sure that Tyler is that monster at the beginning, at the end of episode one. I mean, come on, tell me it wouldn't be perfect. Number one, he's exactly what his dad is investigating. Number two, like, if he is a potential love interest for Wednesday, like, who better for her to date than a monster? Like, come on. And then, tell me that this guy right here isn't the same as this guy. Like, tell me that these two aren't the same. Look at those eyes. But yeah, I'm pretty sure it's Tyler. I'm pretty sure Tyler's got some secrets. I don't know if that was supposed to be obvious, and if it was, you guys can just call me in the comments. But yeah, either way, I really enjoyed the first episode of this show, and I'm so ready to get into this. So thank you so much for joining me. Let's do it.
The story's about to take a dark turn.
Oh, it didn't already?
Usually I love dark turns, but not this one.
You're searching for your son, dude.
I've been searching for hours, Sheriff. The dogs need a break. You think we missed something?
I say we double back, sweep Collet Creek, and then call it a night.
How could you miss a dead body?
Because it wasn't there. No footprints, no blood, no sign of a struggle, nothing. Not
what?
My search party looked all night.
Well, your search party must have left their seeing eye dogs at home.
Did you get a good look at this monster thing?
It didn't stick around for a chat.
Maybe it was one of your classmates.
Sheriff, I find that question offensive.
Well, I don't care, because I got three other dead bodies in the morgue.
Maybe it's your son.
Just ripped apart.
My guess is run away.
That is an extravagant fireplace.
State troopers have put out an alert, and I've contacted his family, but they haven't heard from him either. You have 5 minutes, and everything is off the record. Play nice.
I wonder, does she have any kind of supernatural powers or abilities? I mean, if she went to Nevermore, she must.
Someone is trying to cover up Rowan's murder. That's the only reason to scrub the crime scene.
Is that your professional opinion as the daughter of a murderer?
My father is twice the man you are. And the only thing he murders is the occasional opera in the shower.
It's been a long night and I'm tired of your games.
I'm not playing games. I'm telling the truth. Because you and I both know that there's a monster out there. And Rowan is his latest victim.
You're gonna want to see this.
Oh my god, of course he's back.
Clearly Nevermore's most famous alumni picked that up here. No wonder he became a drug-addled madman.
Edgar Allan Poe went to Nevermore? That's hilarious.
And look, you made it through an entire session without trying to escape. I'll take that as a win.
Guess you decided to stick around Jericho. But you see Dr. Kimbot too?
You should know I'm legally required to be here. Look at us. A couple of teenage tearaways.
Not.
This dude has the exact same eyes as the monster.
Get in touch with a rebel. You know, for the record, I believe you.
Yeah, because you were there.
Howdy, Rumi.
I'm so glad you decided to stay.
I thought you wanted your single room back.
Full disclosure, I don't like living solo, and Thing gives a killer neck massage. It's a win-win.
Are you sure he's not choking you?
I refuse to play the role of a pawn in someone else's corrupt game.
You mean Rowan?
I witnessed his murder, Enid.
It's just, we all saw him this morning, very much like, not dead.
I know, which leads me to believe I've been losing my mind.
What's Rowan's ability?
It's
oh no, I forgot. He has telekinesis.
Yoko, come on, flare those whiskers. The poke up droops for no one.
The references are unending in this show.
Park, want to take a stab at being social?
No. Why would I do that?
The social part, not so much. Besides, it'll cut into my writing time. Maybe it's time to lean into it.
What is this? Some National Treasure type stuff.
You had a psychic vision, didn't you?
Oh, how you know about them?
I realized you might be having them when we passed by the accident in Newport Farm.
She is keen.
Your mother started having visions around your age.
Oh, really?
They were notoriously unreliable and dangerous. I remember at first, she thought she might be losing her mind. Have you spoken to her about them?
Okay, this
is getting the person withholding information. No doubt you'll find something that tickles your fancy.
The last person who tickled me lost a finger.
Here's a little song I wrote. You might want to sing it over and over. Be happy.
You actually showed up.
Man, I love acapella groups, not even gonna lie.
Yellow side out. Three fingers.
I've always wanted to learn archery.
Pull back and let it fly.
He's not all that great at it.
Any questions?
When's the last time you saw your roommate, Rowan?
Oh, you mean the one that was killed by a monster? The last couple weeks he's been more erratic. You know, telekinesis can mess with your head, you know, he's started to freak me out.
How? How can telekinesis mess with you your Tyler? Head?
I'm sorry, were you the only one who got to ask non-archery questions here?
There is no deal. He was doing me a favor, driving me out of town.
Yeah, word of advice, steer clear.
Why, because he's a normie? Because
Tyler and his friends are a bunch of jerks.
At least I'm not an elitist snob.
Oh, she about to show him what's good. Like, I really didn't need your instructions.
We need to talk.
Wednesday? I'm not allowed to speak to anyone.
Where did you get that drawing?
I just went into the woods to clear my head. Then you came after me.
Wednesday. You shouldn't be here.
Oh, what? This man just left a whole persona in the bathroom. Oh, what? What is going on?
I see you finally made a friend. Even if it is a plant.
I go for quality over quantity.
She is never short on quips. Like, she just snapped back so easily. Oh, bro, is he about to make it come alive? Yes! I want this to be my power.
I doubt Wednesday is impressed by your tricks.
Hold on now.
Admit it, you're a little impressed.
Wednesday.
I snapped at you. I'll check my tone in the future. Now chop chop before all our leads turn cold.
He's like, that's as close to an apology as you're getting.
I know I'm stubborn, single-minded, and obsessive. But those are all traits of great writers. Yes, and serial killers. What's your point? When Rowan showed me this, it confirmed my greatest fear. That I'm going to be responsible for something terrible. Not good terrible, like Ivan. Bad terrible. And I can't let that happen.
Oh, she does have a heart.
I should be thanking you. This is the most girls I've ever had in the shed. Other than Beast.
Shocking.
I've always had a thing for werewolf chicks.
Hey, take your wins where you can get them, my guy. I like his positive attitude.
In ancient times, honey was used to treat wounds and in sacrificial burial rites. Cleopatra was rumored to bathe in honey, gave her skin a luminous glow. You ever taken a honey bath?
Oh, whoa, man. It's too far. Too far too soon. Like the confidence, but tone it back a little. Bro, it's like, yes, I got my own room now.
That purple book's gotta be around here somewhere. Start investigating.
Okay. You should close the book back, because he's going to know he didn't leave it on that page.
Rowan's full of surprises.
Oof.
I make one mistake and you can't forgive me. She treats you like crap and you can't get enough.
Okay, why are you so fixated on Wednesday?
Because she thinks she's better than everyone else. I can't wait to crush Ophelia Hall tomorrow and watch her werewolf roommate crumble.
Have you been? I'm literally having a heart attack right now. Yoko is in the infirmary.
What happened?
Garlic bread incident at dinner. She had a major allergic reaction, which means she's out of the poke up and I don't have a co-pilot. You're joining the Black Cats. You're willing to do that? For me?
She's like, don't hug me.
I want to humiliate Bianca so badly that the bitter taste of defeat burns in her throat.
Yeah, but mostly you're doing it because we're friends.
Tell me how she keeps winning.
Your costume's in the tent.
Costume?
Oh, okay. You look perfect.
Only thing, where are your whiskers? Ask again and you'll be done.
She looks more like a bat than a cat right now, though. Oh, she got a crush? Oh, it's the guy from earlier with the snakes. He looks like Heath Ledger's Joker.
The runt of the litter.
For the record, I don't believe I'm better than everyone else. Just that I'm better than you.
I want to welcome you all to...
Okay, so there are male sirens. I wasn't sure if they were or not. Oh, really? Oh, they're executioners, not nuns. Makes more sense now. Wow, the integrity of your boat was very weak. They're the spiders, and they're dressed like the Dornish people from Game of Thrones, low-key with their color scheme.
Thing.
Oh, we got gadgets. Let's go. Really, y'all gonna get sidetracked off of that, bro? How dare you flip us the bird? Later, Wednesday. Oh no. Oh, what? She went to the spirit world? Is that Rowan's mom? Oh no. What?
The key.
Taking a cat nap?
Well, that was trippy. Homie is strong. Get him, thing. I love how he dives in like an actual diver. The amount of times they've caught up to the pack, they are like, you gotta be the fastest team out there. Let's go. They had the best costume design anyway.
The first poker
she's not smiling.
in 1897 as a way to not only honor Nevermore's
She's like, I'm leaving now. It's the book you've been looking for.
What are you doing down here?
Hiding. People keep randomly smiling at me out there. It's unsettling.
It's called having your moment. You took down Bianca Barclay. Try to enjoy it.
That was probably her best line. People keep randomly smiling at me.
Good to see you fitting in.
The answer will give a sharp cracking sound.
Oh, look at that shot. Hey. Oh, that was dope. I do know that about the Addams Family. So that looked like that was Edgar Allan Poe himself. So like that drawing doesn't seem like it would be from dark. Well, the plot thickens. Alright, so that was episode 2. I'm enjoying the whole school vibe and how you got like different classes of people that they all got different abilities. I've always kind of been into that idea. I like the X-Men, I like Strange Academy. I've never seen Harry Potter, but I mean, I guess maybe I'll be into that if I'd seen it. But yeah, just the whole idea of you got like these different groups within the school hierarchy who have like their own abilities and things like that. It goes very well with this whole kind of teenage drama idea, but man, the plot keeps thickening and it's just like, I don't know who to trust. Obviously no one in this entire story can you trust because everybody's up to some shady stuff. Everybody's got their own nefarious deeds. I don't know what the principal is up to. Like, what is her end game? I have no idea what she could possibly be up to. Still definitely think Tyler is a monster. I feel like they're starting to make it a little more clear throughout the episodes, and I don't know how his dad's gonna take it. Low-key almost kind of feels like his dad suspects him of being a monster, but maybe he just resents his son for whatever reason. And then also I'm not sure if I trust the one normie teacher at the school. She seems good, but every now and then it's just, I don't know, I get some strange vibes from her. So I don't really know like who to trust. I don't know who to be suspicious of right now because everybody seems to be on some shady stuff. But yeah, I dig it. Oh, we did get the which was a very iconic Addams Family thing, you know, the da-na-na-na, 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 da-na-na-na. But that's cool how they kind of tied that in there. I don't know what the whole significance of it was back in the day, but it's cool how they tied it in with the whole sequence of Edgar Allan Poe's thing. Mystery and more plot thickening. But that's going to do it for today's video, guys. Thank you so much for joining me. Remember to drink some water. And if no one's told you today, just know that I love you. Peace out, everybody.